Hello everybody, Bill here from QA1.
Tate here.
And today we're going to talk to you about springs, different kinds of springs, and what the spring rate actually means. There's a bunch of different kinds of springs to be aware of. Mostly what we deal with in the coilover world and in the performance car and truck market is coil springs, right? And you can put them on your shock and have a coilover. You can keep them away from the shock, and then it's not technically a coilover, but it still has a coil spring, right? Coil simply means it's coiled. But there's also different kinds of springs. There's leaf springs. This is a leaf spring off of a Corvette, common to find them under the back ends of pickup trucks, old cars, front ends of old pickup trucks and old cars. Coil springs started coming around mostly in the 50s.
Say in the 50s, yeah.
Around the 50s, and that's primarily what you still see today. There's torsion springs, which are like a long bar that gets twisted. A sway bar is an example of a torsion spring. All of them are doing the same thing. They're just resisting, basically. If you compress this spring, if I push this way on the spring's pushing back that way, right? If I push down on these two points on this spring, then the center's pushing up, right? So they're all doing the same thing. They're just resisting. They're pushing back when you push on them.
Pushing back against the force that's there.
Yep. Now that you know what springs are and the different kinds of them, you can get a little bit more technical. And the way springs are generally looked at or talked about is in spring rate. So what is spring rate? It's simply a measurement of how much force it takes to compress a spring a given amount. Here in America, we say pounds per inch. In Europe and Asia, they use kilograms per millimeter. They're giving you the same information, just in different units. Here, what we use, pounds per inch. This is a 12 pound per inch spring, which means that it takes 12 pounds to compress a spring 1 inch, takes another 12 pounds to compress a spring a second inch, so on and so forth. So one thing you can do with springs, if you know what your spring rate is, and we do this all the time, is if you know what the spring rate is, you can measure how long it is when this car is on them, and then you can use that measurement. So say this is a 10 inch spring and it's compressing down to 7 inches. It tells us that we're compressing 3 inches from the free length, right? And if we know the free length and how far it's compressing and the spring rate, we can tell you how much force is on that spring. So you can actually use a spring as like a scale.
Right. You can get the sprung weight.
Yep.
From a vehicle, less the unsprung weight, which is a pretty nice way to figure out where you need to be for spring rate or where you're at.
Yep, they're pretty handy. So if we can tell how much force is on a spring, okay, that's great. But how do we know if that's too much, too little? What are we looking for?
A lot of what you're going to experience in driving is going to tell you about where you're at for spring rate. If you notice you have a lot of body roll, a lot of nosedive under braking, that may well be a sign that you are undersprung, have too soft of a spring. If you are feeling everything on the road and it's really harsh, you're probably oversprung. These are things that can be easily corrected again by taking stock of the compressed length of the spring and putting the math to it and correcting that, and we can usually get a lot closer.
Well, I hope that demystified springs a little bit for you. If you have any questions at all, feel free to give us a call on the tech line, send us an email.
And if you do want to look into any of this further, we have lots of information in our tech articles at our website, qa1.net.